Hey guys, thanks for checking out this video. My name is Roberto. I'm really excited to share with you an incredible true story that I recently came across. It's the story of Nathan Harmon. You know, if you've ever felt like just you need a clean slate, you need a fresh start, that you've made too many mistakes, but you really desire for just a second chance, for forgiveness, Nathan's story is gonna speak to you. He has a powerful story. He was responsible for the death of somebody, and his life was in a path of self-destruction. But something happened, something miraculous happened in his life that changed his life forever. I want you to take a few minutes and watch his story. Wait till the end. I'd love to hear what you think. Check it out.
My dad sat down and looked at my sister and looked at me and said, "Your mother and I are going to separate. We're going to get a divorce." And that blindsided me.
At first, it didn't make sense to 12-year-old Nathan Harmon why his parents divorced. In his eyes, they were good Christians who raised their family to love and trust God. Later, the pieces started coming together.
I began to find out slowly that my dad struggled with alcohol, my mom struggled with alcohol. My dad had some struggles with some fidelity. It broke me because I thought our family was that cookie cutter family that was perfect. I remember looking at them both and saying, "I will never be like you."
Nathan felt his parents weren't the only ones who had betrayed him.
I began to attach my emotion and the blame a lot on God. And so I got angry at God.
He slowly turned away from church.
By my junior, I was a full-blown alcoholic. I'm smoking marijuana. I'm snorting cocaine. I'm popping pills. I want to feel loved. I want to feel accepted. I'm trying to feel hurts and pains. And so instead of now leaning towards God and the youth groups and the body of people around me that care, those voids are still there. Now I'm plugging it with alcohol and I'm plugging it with getting high.
His senior year, Nathan was expelled for skipping school and failing his classes. Afterwards, he joined the Army, trying to get a new start.
I was serious about changing my life. That was a moment that I was like, I'm gonna come back from the Army and I'm gonna be different and I'm going to be a totally brand new man.
But after boot camp, he fell back to his old habits and was kicked out of the Army for drugs and going AWOL. He stayed with friends and worked minimum wage jobs, spending his money on alcohol. By now, he felt even God wouldn't want him.
I just began to really believe that I had made too many mistakes, and this is all that life has for you now. It was drugs, alcohol, and nothingness. Just a sense of hopelessness, you know.
Then late one Friday, Nathan met up with a friend at a bar, and they decided to go to a party.
I was really drunk. She had just showed up, she was sober, but the process from leaving the bar and getting into her Jeep, somehow I got the keys. The next thing I remember was her just scream, "Tree." And I looked right, and I see her blonde hair and her face, and everything froze. And I just hear like that word, "Tree." And it was black. I woke up then, I was in a helicopter. And it was windy, and it was cold. And I woke up in a hospital with police officers over top of me asking me questions. And I was asking, what's going on? Because I'm clueless, my ankle's throbbing, it's broken. And they said, "Well, you were in a bad accident. You hit a tree."
Nathan asked about his friend, but got no answers. By now, his mom was there and took him home with her. The next morning, he went out to get the paper.
And I unroll it, and I look at the headline, and it says, "Crash, victim, dies." And my world just stops. Shame, I mean, guilt, I can't even fathom. And here I sit, 23, the reality that I'm responsible for killing somebody.
A few days later, Nathan heard that the woman's family asked him to contact them.
I didn't know what to expect. How do you even begin to pick up a phone and call somebody and say, "I'm sorry"? But I did. And they just right away just said, "Nathan, we just want you to know that there's no reason that two lives and two families are destroyed from one poor choice." And this family said, "I forgive you. I didn't deserve a family to forgive me. If anything, I deserved to be the kid that got what he finally deserved. I deserved them to hate me. I deserved them to want me in prison for the rest of my life. I deserved my life to be over. And when that family just said, "We forgive you," and they meant it, it messed my world up. I couldn't explain it. And I couldn't keep running from God.
Later, Nathan was arrested and charged with reckless homicide. He recalls his first night in jail, the same night he surrendered his life to Jesus Christ.
I said, "God, I have no idea what's ahead of me. I have no idea how long I'm going to be gone for. But regardless if it's 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, I need you in my life. Forgive me." And this is the most unbelievable presence of God. It seemed like it just filled up that cell. And I had such a peace.
Nathan signed a plea agreement for 15 years with 5 suspended. From the start, he used his time behind bars to serve God.
I began to really just pursue everything that God had for me and letting my life now be his life for him to use as that, just to be his hands and feet, you know, to teach people how to love, live, and look like Jesus, to let people know there's hope.
Nathan was released after just 2.5 years. Today, he's a pastor and speaker sharing how God's grace can free you from the burdens of your past.
No matter what I did, the plan would fail, but I never got what I deserved. And it was always that grace and it was always that mercy. God was just after me. It's what God's after all of us. Jesus is just pursuing us, you know?
What an incredible testimony of forgiveness and redemption. You know, I think it's incredible that Nathan experienced the forgiveness from this beautiful family. Can you imagine calling the family and just hearing from their own mouth that they forgive you? You know, I really believe that that kind of strength and that kind of mercy and grace, only God can give that. Only God can do that in a heart. And you may be watching this and you may be thinking, you know, Nathan's story is incredible, it's great, but you know, I don't know if it's for me. I've made too many mistakes or I'm beyond hope, but I'm here to tell you that it's not true. You are within the reach of grace. Jesus is pursuing you. He is after your heart. And I can tell you from experience that his forgiveness, his restoration is real. He really is after you. And he wants to do something beautiful in your life. He wants to redeem you, just like he did with Nathan. And today, you may be thinking, so what's next? What do I have to do? Like, how can I get this new life? How can I get this joy and this incredible new start that Nathan experienced? You know, it's actually simple. Jesus already did everything for you. He came 2,000 years ago. He died for you. He carried your brokenness, your sin, everything that's wrong with you, all your letdowns, all your mistakes. He carried them on the cross and he died for you. But he didn't stay there. He resurrected. He came back to life and he's Lord of all. And he's making something new today. And he wants you to come home. He wants to give you a fresh start. So I want to invite you, if that's you, if you've been longing for a clean slate, if you've been longing for just a fresh start and you want that shame, that lack of sleep at night, that condemnation to go away, Jesus is knocking at the door of your heart and he wants to give that to you. So I want to invite you to pray with me. It's very simple. Pray with me with faith. That means just trust, believe in your heart that what Nathan experienced, that what I have experienced is real. Give Jesus a chance. You will not be disappointed. So pray with me right there. Jesus, I thank you that you are real and that you are good. I ask you today, Lord, come into my life. Make me new. Forgive me of all my sin, all my wrongdoing, every mistake that I've made. I know that I need you. I know that I've missed the mark, but I put my trust in you. I believe that you died for my sins, for everything that I've done wrong. Lord, I want a fresh start. I want you to forgive me. Make me whole. Come into my life. Holy Spirit, breathe life in me. The Spirit of God. Spirit of God, come. Make me new. I believe and I pray this in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. I want to congratulate you. I'm so excited for you. Today, you've made the most important decision of your life. And I want to hear from you. Would you do something for me? It's very simple. call this number, 1-800-700-7000. We want to hear from you. We want to just pray with you and rejoice with you. We have a gift for you. If you call 1-800-700-7000, we're going to get you a free gift. So, hey, check it out. And if you don't want to call or you just want to click, there's a link in the description. Click for it for more resources. Thank you for watching. And I am so excited for you. Your journey of faith has just begun. God bless you.